got the top spot title. Spent an hour in the bathroom, walked out looking like a model. God, doing what you do, got me right there with Apollo on the moon. Moonies, genies in a bottle, girl, if they already got you.
Things people ask lesbians.
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 Because we're lesbians.
Lesbians.
Yo. Swag. First question. What exactly do you do?
Google it. I don't know.
What does that even mean? Like, what exactly do we do?
What do you
bed?
Think? What do you think it
in
means?
Bed?
No, like, how do you eat your cereal? How do we eat our cereal different from people? That question really pisses me off, though.
It really does. Like, how do you do it?
How do you guys do it? How?
What?
Like, just... I'm done with this question.
Second question. Number two. Is one of you the man? Okay, well, I guess I would be the man, but...
Isn't the whole point of being a lesbian because you don't want to be with a man?
Right, the whole point of being a lesbian is to date a girl, like, because you aren't attracted to guys. I mean, besides her, she's attracted to Zac Efron, but whatever. No, I guess, like, that's really just the wrong question, that's the wrong way to put it. I mean, I don't want to be a man, and I really don't want to, like, necessarily look like a man. But I do like to be dominant, so...
She wears the pants of the relationship.
Yeah. I guess the question really should be, is there a dominant one? But, you know, people are stupid.
Okay, well, if we're gonna do it that way, then I'm the dominant one.
Okay. Number three, is it easier since you're both women and you know what each other want?
No. 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 No.
No. Because there's times where I don't always know what she wants.
There are times where I don't even know what I want.
Yeah. So, really, I don't know. I don't know how else to put that question.
No.
The answer to that question. It's just no.
No. Ready, Al? What are you doing with your head?
Four. One, two, three, four. If you like women, why would you date a girl that looks like a guy? Why not just date a man? It's two questions in one, but okay. Michelle?
Your phone is dying.
Oh, no.
Okay.
But what was the question? Why not date a man? Because boobs. Well, never mind, you can't really even say that, because some guys do have boobs. Like, if the guy's fat enough, they do have boobs, so. But, like, I don't know.
Okay, well,
because I like
my perspective on this question is, I mean, why not?
Why not?
The actual answer for me to this question is
I'm listening.
Is because the whole it's the same fucking answer at excuse my language. It's the same answer as is one of you the man. You know, we don't date girls. I just don't understand why somebody would date a girl that looks like a man. I'm really not trying, like, I don't look like a man. I know I'm a girl.
Because if
I
wanted to
a vagina, and I know it, okay?
If I wanted to date a guy, I would have dated a guy. I wouldn't have chosen a girl. Like,
chosen.
Like, hello. Yeah, this. Yeah. Question five. And it's
number five.
My favorite question of all. What's the question?
Why are all lesbians obsessed with cats?
Because cats.
Kitty. This is our cat. We adopted her from Teskies.
It's weird though because I've never heard that question before.
Yeah, that's an interesting question.
We didn't get cat because we're lesbians and we thought the cat would signify the fact that we're lesbians.
No, we didn't.
But
that's a good I guess that's the good way to put it. I've never heard that question ever before.
but fun fact of the day, this girl tried to give the cat a bath and
yeah, so
doing good. If you want to take a picture, I suggest you come over here.
Her name's Marley. Say hi, everybody.
Bitch, and she needs to be the claw.
Meow, meow, meow. Yeah, she needs to be the claw.
Why is this six?
Yeah. Because it's a number six. Number six. How do you know you're a lesbian?
When you like girls. When you're sexually attracted. You don't even have to be sexually attracted, I don't think.
Well, I don't know.
Well, I mean, it's got to be a key factor, obviously.
Yeah. When you're 6 years old and you see a girl in the playground and you're like, damn, she's cute.
Okay, well, let's put it this way. How did you know when you were a lesbian? When you were 6 years old and saw a girl who...
I don't know. I can't remember.
I don't know. I can't remember.
Either. Honestly, I look at it like I was born that way.
No, actually, you know what? I did remember when I figured out that I was a lesbian.
Because, soccer.
No. No? Because I was in sixth grade, and this girl had some big old tatas, and...
She went there.
I went, yeah, I did. Oh, I did go there. There was some girl, there was a girl there, and she's had some really big titties, and... I remember saying to one of my best friends, who was probably going to watch this and be like, oh, it was me. No, but I remember telling her that that girl had some really big titties. And she was like, that's gross. And I'm pretty sure we weren't really good friends after that. But, yeah.
That's okay. Well, I remember my story too, but that's totally different. But I don't remember finding out. Or like, okay, well, hi, welcome back. Cat does not like it when we're on the phone, but...
Okay, number seven.
Number seven. Have you ever been with a guy? We both had our first experience with guys.
Together. Together. That's all we're going to say. Because...
There's... Yeah.
That's enough.
Okay. Yes.
Okay.
Right, number eight. Okay. How did you come out? All right, I'll go first.
Can I just go first? Because I don't really have a story about that. I just. All
right, I have a story.
I just started dating a girl one day. So.
Is that it?
That's about it. Yeah.
Well, no, because I know your story. Her story is, okay, she says she just started dating a girl one day. No, she was dating a girl before she was dating me. Nobody knew about it. I'm not going to say the girl's name. Not that it matters. She ain't never going to watch this. But, and it was like a long distance relationship. Why am I telling your story?
Because I don't want my story told.
Oh, well, I'm telling you anyway. It was a long-distance relationship. Don't take my hat. Okay, whatever.
Swag. I look just a beaver.
Oh, my God.
Swag.
But it was a long-distance relationship, and she didn't want anybody to know, and they had a lot of problems. So when she actually came out, she came out to her closest friends and started dating me. And at the time, I was really popular, so it just kind of got around to the whole school. That's what happened. Right? Is that pretty much just the gist of it? Okay, Justin, you were giving me a damn hat.
No. Right.
My story is, in fifth grade, I was best friends with this girl named Brianna. Shout out, Brianna. Prego. It's kind of weird. So long ago. Okay. In fifth grade, I was best friends with this girl named Brianna, and I had this crush on this girl. And I don't know why, but I did. And my stupid self told Brianna, no offense to you, but at the time I was really mad at you. I told Brianna and she told the girl that I had a crush on. And it got around and we were all so young and they were like, ew, gross, titties. That's how it happened. And in sixth grade, because that was towards the end of the year. So in sixth grade, when I went to junior high school, it was pretty awkward for everybody. But yeah, that's pretty much it. That's how I came out. Hey, what's up?
We pulled a switcheroo because I was hungry, so I made bacon.
Yeah. Okay. So we're on, what, number nine?
Number nine! All right. How did your family react when you came out? Again, I'm just gonna tell my story because it's really it's really short.
Right.
There really wasn't a reaction because it just happened and nobody really said anything about it. And they never have, so.
And, well, they don't like me, but that's not because, I don't know if that's because she's gay or not. Probably just because I'm an asshole, but, my dad is a very quiet man, and he never really said anything about it until not even a couple years ago. Yeah, about a couple years ago, when he was drunk and arguing with my mom. But my mom, on the other hand, she was pissed off, and she was like, I remember one day I came home because she had gotten a call from a counselor or something, or talked to my counselor in sixth grade, and I came home and she talked to me and she was crying and she told me it was just a phase, and that was her story for a while. It's just a phase. But she kind of grew out of it. I don't think she likes the idea, but...
But it's okay now.
It's okay now. But the thing with my dad is, it's funny, he reacted funny, because when he finally reacted, his reaction when he was drunk, he basically just was screaming and yelling at her about how she can't control who I am, and he may not agree with it, but he's not going to fight with me about it. I love you, Dad. I love you too, Mom. Whatever.
Last but not least, question number 10 is how long have we been together and where did we meet?
Yeah. We met in school, in high school.
In high school. Yeah. I'm pretty sure everybody and their mom knows that. Everybody and their mom knows that. Okay. And number 2 is we've been together for 2 years in February. February 2nd will be 2 years. Two crazy, long, annoying, stressful, I want to kill you years. So.
Love you too.
Swag.
Swag!